Adonai, Nishmat Adam. The lamp of God is the soul of man and woman. Within each of us is a divine spark that brings light into the world. Within each of us is a gift given from God, a purpose for our being here.
Tonight, I pray for the ability to reach deep within, to use the divine spark within me along with the melodies and harmonies of holy compositions to even for a moment lift myself off the earth. Nishmat Adam Ner, Nishmat Adam Ner, Ner Adonai.
When we seek to evoke or express emotion, we turn to music. Music is the soul to the universe, wings to the mind, flight to the imagination, and charm and gaiety to life and to everything. There is an interconnection between music and the spirit. When language aspires to the transcendent and the soul longs to break free of the gravitational pull of the earth, it modulates into song. Music is a language which the soul alone understands, but which the soul can never translate.
Perhaps it's only in a dream, never to be found or be seen. But somewhere, heaven and earth touch. I stop and look for miracles of better things to come. Perhaps I'm just too close to see. The miracle is you and me. I want to believe in a better day. I want to believe. I want to believe. I want to believe in a better to believe that heaven and earth touch someplace. In every laugh, in every tear, in every joy, in every fear, somewhere heaven and earth touch. Every light of every day, in everything, in every way, somewhere, heaven and earth touch. I stop and look for miracles of better things to come. Perhaps I'm just too close to see. The miracle is you and me. I want to believe in a better day. I want to believe. I want to believe. I want to believe in a better day. Someplace we look, but do we see? We listen, but do we hear? We touch, but do we feel? The signs are there, they are real. I want to believe in a better. To believe, I need to believe in a better way, and I want to believe that heaven and earth touch someplace. Not sure where, I'm not sure how. Maybe later, maybe now.
Well, I'm Cantor Perrine Anker, and I am the Associate Dean of the Cantorial School at AJRCA, Academy for Jewish Religion, California. First, I'd like to thank Temple Emanuel, Cantor Yonah Klieger, Rabbi Laura Geller, Rabbi Sarah Basson, and Rabbi Jonathan Ahrens for welcoming Lizzie to her home. I think most of you know that this has been her home for a long time, and they've opened the doors to invite her to do her concert here this evening. Well, Lizzie is a spirit, and Lizzie is a force, and we know that. What Lizzie brings tonight to all of us is her love for Jewish music, her love for the synagogue, her love for her people and people in general. What Lizzie brings is her love of musical theater, which, combined with her love of the holy words, makes all the words holy and makes all the words available and touchable for all of us. So as you see in your program, this is Lizzie's graduation recital. It's her master's recital. She has produced a wonderful thesis. And soon we will be able to call her Cantor Lizzie Weiss. It has been my pleasure, truly my pleasure, to be her teacher since she was a young teen, her mentor, one of her mentors all of these years, and to share this night with all of you.
The heavens declare the glory of God. The skies proclaim the work of the divine hands. There is no speech, there are no words. Their music carries throughout the earth to the end of the world. Beneath the silence, available only to the inner ear, creation sings. Nekadesh, nekadesh et shimcha, ba'olam. Harmony. The song is found in the Slichot liturgy, B'motzei Menucha, even as we transition into the precious days of the Yamim Noraim. We must recall that it was God that created us. It is God that can provide relief from our suffering by granting us mercy.
Yotzer ata lechol yatzir.
Of mystical study is on the secret of Shabbat, Raza de Shabbat. It is on Shabbat that our very prayers are raised up and perfected. Shabbat is unified with the holy light. She is adorned with crowns, and even if just for a moment, the evil forces of the world are uprooted, her face is radiant with divine light, and she is adorned below with the holy people.
Bine hiru ilan קדישה וכולי חון מיתרין בנשמתים חדיתין בנשמתים חדיתים בנשמתים חדיתין כדין שעות הדיצותה לבחלה
is based on my thesis, which was called The Music of Heaven, and I explored how the mystics viewed music and how that really affects our practice today. And there's so many elements, but I think my favorite thing that I got out of this with the help of Cantor Jonathan Friedman, who, if you don't know him, you should. is represented by this quote. Music is forever the best example of continual creation. Even when we sing ancient liturgy, we're reproducing the spirit of when the piece was originally conceived. With each new prayer, we are truly singing a new song unto God. And I am so honored to be singing a new song, not a new song, but we will be recreating this new song, Shiru Ladonai, with my mentor, Cantor Yona Klieger.
On behalf of Temple Emanuel, Rabbi Geller and Rabbi Aaron and Rabbi Bassin, I want to formally welcome you all here tonight for a night that, for us, this is auspicious. We haven't had a cantor come through our ranks in our congregational memory. And Lizzie, you are not my memory since I've been here. You know, it says in the Torah that God hardened Pharaoh's heart. You have opened our hearts tonight. Yeah. This is the definition of kvelling right here. And I had more that I wanted to say, but I just kind of want to let our music speak for itself.
Adonai shir chadash Tehilato mikzei haaretz Shiru
Yotei hayam melo
Yordan ויוס ויה. Shiru, 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 latunai. Shiru, 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 shir chadash. Tehilato mikze haaret, shiru, latunai. Tehilato mikze haaret, shiru, latunai. Shiru, 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 latunai. Shiru, 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 shir chadash. Tehilato mikze haaret, shiru, latunai. Tehilato mikze haaret, shiru, latunai. Shiru, latunai, shir chadash. Tehilato mikze haaret, shiru. Yordei hayam umlo iyim iyim veyos vehem. Yordei hayam umlo iyim iyim veyos vehem. Shiru 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 latonai. Shiru 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 hadash. Tehilato mikze haaret shiru latonai. Tehilato mikze haaret shiru latonai. Shiru latonai shir chadash. Tehilato mikze haaret shiru shiru.
Studying. Baruch she'amar v'haya ha'olam. God spoke and the world came to be. This one line, which is chanted every morning, highlights the mystic's view of language as the basis of creation. It is a magnificent vision to imagine words with such power that they could literally create the sea and the stars. God could create the world with language, and if humankind is created in the image of God, then speech and language must be a magnificent force of nature. Tonight, I am blessed, blessed, blessed to introduce three new pieces to you. The first two, which we're about to do now, not at the same time, are about the essence of creation. Marcia Atti, a friend, a soon-to-be colleague, a peer, a coach, a mentor, everything that she can be. I approached Marcia. I had this vision of a new Baruch Shemar, and I knew that Marcia was the one to write it, and I had like this vision of it. I can't even describe it. And she truly, truly, I created it. And so here we go. Here is Baruch Shemar with women that support me and that I love.
Praise be the one who spoke the world into being. Praise and blessing. Praise.
I hadn't known Marcia, well, then I wouldn't have met this next amazing person who I am sure, well, I hope, are you here? Yes, you are. That, that we will continue this collaboration as the years go on, because it has been so fulfilling and so uplifting. And so now, here is First You Made Light by the brilliant Daniel Leance.
Maker of all.
Heschel said, it wouldn't be a concert if you didn't quote Abraham Joshua Heschel. My older brother told me that. Hi, Scott. Okay. Our goal should be to live life in radical amazement. Get up in the morning and look at the world in a way that takes nothing for granted. Everything is phenomenal. Everything is incredible. Never treat life casually. To be spiritual is to be amazed. You have seen and you will see tonight that there are many ways to call for the gates of heaven to open. In this next piece, Susharim, you will see that sometimes the grander the better.
Made life. before. But people don't understand when they ask me, when is your birthday? And I reply, our birthday is October 25th. I mean, they truly think I'm crazy. And there's your introduction. So with that, I call up my triplet brother and sister, Sarah and Ryan. Soon to be Cantor Sarah Haas.
Sorry, it's been bugging me the whole time.
Oh, you can edit that, right? Oh, are we using, okay, you get this, I get five. Sorry, okay. Rye, it's all you.
Okay. So Lizzie asked me to say something before, and I never turned down an opportunity to speak. So I was thinking, this song that we're about to sing is called Light. And in the wisdom traditions, another word for light is knowledge. And I recently learned that, so in the West, we think about knowledge, we think about knowing things, and we think about our brain. But in the East, the word for mind and the word for heart is the same word. So the belief is that our real knowledge is what lies in our heart, our feelings, and that it's actually the thoughts from our head that block us from that knowledge. And so the thoughts in our head are the darkness. And what you asked me to tell you was this idea that it's like we're all standing in a super bright room with our hands in front of our eyes, complaining that it's dark. And if we could just learn to lower our eyes, our hand, and feel our feelings, and let that be enough, which I think Lizzie has really given us the opportunity to do tonight so beautifully. So this is light.
We need some light. First of all, we need some light. You can't sit here and all alone, it's a sorry sight. It's just you and me. Live, you'll see.
Night after night, we'd sit and wait for the morning. But we've waited far too long for all that's wrong to be made right.
Day after day, wishing all our cares away, trying to fight the things we feel, but some hurts never heal. Some ghosts are never gone, but we go on. We still go on, and you find some way to survive, and you find out you don't have to be happy at all.
Price of love is lost,
but still we pay. We love anyway.
on, and when we see the new day dawn, we'll wonder how we wandered for so long, so blind. The wasted world we thought we knew, the light will make it look brand new, so
amazement. And I do. And people will say to me, how do you keep doing that? And it's just, I don't know. I say I'm blessed to be able to look at the positive in every single opportunity. And as I stand here today, I reflect on so many years in my life that got me here. So many experiences, one of which everybody knows was my many, many years at Camp Swig. You know, and I started Camp Swig in 1993 or 1994. By the way, Marsha was my song leader when I was in the sixth grade, and then all of a sudden, and she was amazing, and she always was the first one to give you the microphone and say, you sing. And that's who she is as a person. And then I walked into AJR, like, you know, 15 years later, and there was Marsha. Anyway, and I'm stalling, and Julie Silver, who I do not lie when I say that her music has been a pulse in our Jewish life, in the life of my immediate family, in the life of my uncle who passed away last year. And his memory is a blessing, as tonight, Julie and I stand and sing this new Pit Chuli. I came to Julie and said, will you write me a Pit Chuli? And Julie already has a fantastic Pit Chuli, but I use that one. Oh, is this the right one? Yeah. Okay, sorry. The last six, well, Julie, can you talk? I can't talk anymore.
Lizzie, you are making all of us very proud, and you make us smile, and you're making us sing, and you're making me cry, and I think I met you in that summer of 1993, and your siblings, and your family means a lot to me, and your uncle, Ken, would be amazed and proud and not surprised, not surprised. Want to sing the song?
Yes.
You know, we actually, when we thought, Lizzie was such a muse in writing this song and to me, and we wrote, we talked about it. She was such a great teacher for me. When I wrote a setting for Pit Chuli 20-something years ago, I wrote it with great urgency. Open the gates. For me, open the gates for me. For many reasons, I wanted those gates open and I wanted to walk in. And it was through Lizzie and our studying this text together that I figured out those gates are always open. It is we who need to be aware that they're always open. Walk through them together. So this is the song, and the chorus is antiphonal, so I hope it'll all be revealed.
In time.
Yes.
Sometimes I lose my way, I stumble and fall, I fail to see the open door and only see a wall. Sometimes I close my ears when open they should be, but then I stop and listen to that still small voice inside of me.
Pete Hooley,
Pete Hooley,
Shared Sede,
Shared Sede,
Avova,
Avova.
Do something that I would not ordinarily do. Well, this whole thing's not ordinary, but I'm going to invite up some people who gave and gave and gave and gave to make tonight happen. I was just a little pawn, I feel like, and there were people who really rallied around me to get me to this moment. These composers, Julie and Danny and Marsha, who please come up, who did not just, these are not people, I mean, not that I'm surprised, but they spent hours talking on the phone with me, rehearsing with me for hours, and I'm changed. I also want to invite up Cantor Yona Klieger, Cantor Perrine Anker, and Bill Schmidt. If you don't know Bill Schmidt, you should know Bill Schmidt, and Chris Harden, who, by the way, transcribed most of the pieces for tonight. Chris, do you hear me? He's being coy. And the reason why I'm inviting them up is because I have a gift that I want to give them, and I want you to see it, because I worked really hard on it. And so here we go, before we do the last piece. Cantor, Sam Radwine, there you are. Oh my gosh, who conducted this concert and came all the way from Palm Desert? Oh, Palm
Desert. You're our present, Lizzie.
Wow. What, did it say your name on it?
Lizzie, you are so sweet.
What, Daniel?
Are you kidding?
Yeah.
Thank you.
Don't open it yet. We'll do it on three. Marsha, sorry, I know this is really weird, but... There's this other side of my brain that you'll see comes out. Okay, you don't have to open the card right now, but open the gift. It's some work I did to try and represent this moment. Yeah, they're all different.
You want to reuse?
Oh, sorry, there's your sample. Throw the paper on the ground. And you guys can look at them later, but I'm really, they are collaboration here. I'll show it up from Julie. Julie, can I have this for a second?
Show it.
Okay, so like this is Marsha's Baruch Shamar, and it has her sheet music and just stuff. And as I was practicing music, these were like the inspiration for these gifts that I hope will start to begin to say thank you to these people who have given me so much for my life. So now we can forget all of that nonsense and end with something that means so, so, so much to me. As I thought about my thesis, 3 years ago, I went to who I believe is one of the greatest musical theater composers of all time, Jason Robert Brown, and began a discussion with him. He has won Tonys for Parade and Bridges of Madison County and Honeymoon in Vegas, which is on Broadway right now, which is closing, but unfortunately. The last 5 years in Songs for New World, he writes music that it's not religious music, but it's religious to me. And I asked him if we'd become friends, if he would write a kedusha. And unfortunately, just as time went on, this year, of course, happened to be the year that he had two Broadway shows and a national tour and a movie. And unfortunately, about 2 months ago, he emailed me and he said, Lizzie, I hate to do this, but this is not going to be done in time. And I said, okay, eventually. And I got in my car, and I turned on one of his CDs, and this next song played, and it all made sense. All of the studying that I had been doing just came to a halt. And so this is the music of heaven. Now they're gonna get into place, and I wanna say one thing, which is that you know, the people at Temple Emanuel, Cantor Yonah Klieger, Tina Kaplan Weiss, the rabbis, they empowered me. They didn't say, stand in a line and sing X, Y, and Z. They said, get out there and pray, and use your voice and pray. And this is a message that we have to pass on to our young singers in Temple. And I want to say that I've started to do my part with this little 9-year-old that I live with. Yes, I live with him. And he's been singing this song for about 5 years now. And we were singing it recently, and I went, wait, this song is the equivalent to Music of Heaven, but for a little boy. And so, if I dare, I'm going to invite up Jaden. He's my nephew. He's the little 9-year-old I live with who happens to be my nephew. Okay, are you going to stand here?
I don't care where.
Do you want to stand?
So alone in the universe, my own planets and stars are glowing. No one notices anything, not one person is listening.
Thinking I'm smarter or just more realistic, I sit with my frozen smile all the while, reluctant to trust what I'm told. Cynical, cold, challenging Music of Heaven to open a crack in my chest and let something glorious in. Music of Heaven should puncture me, suddenly blessed, blessed, blessed. Let the music begin. Let the music begin. They sing and they cry and I watch, lean back in my chair. The classic New Yorker, alone among millions. Indifference upon my face, out of place, but longing to feel what you feel, like it was real, like there could be Music of Heaven to some path to my soul and let something glorious in. The music of heaven allows you to give up control. Yes, yes, let the music begin. Let the music begin. And I sit there with dry eyes and cold hands, judging and standing apart. Let the music begin. Let the music begin. Let the music begin. Let the music begin.
Before I say anything, I just want to say, wow. So for those who don't know who I am, I'm Cantor Nathan Lamb. I'm the dean of the Cantorial School of the Academy for Jewish Religion in California. So before we get to you, I'd like to introduce, first of all, the faculty. If we have faculty members here from our school, please stand up. We'll give them a round of applause. The administrators, please stand up. Dr. Tamar Frankiel, our president. Is that Robin back there? Yes, Robin, thank you. And without our wonderful lay leadership and our board, we would not be able to keep the school going. So I want to ask Rabbi Laura Owens and anybody else who's on the board to please stand up and give them a round of applause. If you're one of our alums, I want you to stand up too. And everybody's been thanked, Temple Emanuel, all of your mentors. And now I'm going to say something to you. You wanted us to open our hearts tonight. So it says there are a few verses which kind of shout out to me, especially the last number, because when the ministering angels say Kadosh, Kadosh, they say one to another. They don't say it to God. They say one to another, holy, holy, holy is the God of hosts. They say that for a reason. Because when you look at Jacob's ladder, the Torah tells us that an angel should do what? Where does an angel come from? From heaven. So an angel should be coming down the ladder to greet human beings. But it says, it starts off by saying, he says, Manu rahamakom hazeh, how awesome is this place? And I did not know it. And you touched on that, especially with the Pitchuli, that the gates are always open. Anochi lo yadati, and I didn't know it. And then it says, and the angels, heim yordim, heim olim, the yordim bo. They went up the ladder and then came down the ladder. Why would angels be going up the ladder first? Because angels are made here. And you, this evening, made us feel like we're the angels going up that ladder. So, you know how I won't use your nickname tonight. I do with an accent.
Somebody did it for you, it's all right.
Lizzie. Now, I don't know if you've ever been, I know you've been, sometimes, you know, maybe I could detect some sadness, but boy, you have to be Lewis and Clark to find it. Because you always have a smile on your face, and the Pirkei Avot that says, it's a takeoff actually on Micah, it says, you're supposed to greet everybody with a cheerful countenance. And that you do. And if you want to be a cantor, you want to be clay kodesh, you want to be clergy, which we ordain our clergy, rabbis and cantors, and we create chaplains, that if you don't greet your congregants, if you want to be their shliach tzibur, you have to greet them with a cheerful countenance. And then the last quote I'm going to do this evening is Eze hu ashir, who is rich? And we're sitting in Beverly Hills. Or we're actually Beverly Hills because the, how do I know it's Beverly Hills? Because the signs are in white with black letters, not green with white letters. Does that tell us who's wealthy? No. Does it tell us who's rich? It says, Eze hu ashir, what does it say? Sameach b'chelko, one who is happy with their portion. So this evening, I'm going to do a twist on it. It's not sameach b'chelko. It's not one who is happy with their portion, because you are a sameach b'chelka. You are one who's happy with your portion. But you made us sameach b'chelkech. We were happy with your portion. And in samachnu, and we became happy with what you gave us, the portion that you gave us. You have a very eclectic program with incredible music going from Ami Aloni, our dear friend Ami Aloni, to all the rest of the, I don't want to forget anybody, so you just look at the program and look at the names. Look at the names. And you'll see, and what I think is it says to us that we are a very big tent, and we are so proud at AJR at the Academy to have all of this going on, because I believe that we are becoming, we're going to become, we're aspiring to become the center of the Jewish musical world, and that's what our goal is. Not small, not we're going to be the center on Wilshire Boulevard between New Hampshire and Vermont. Okay? We want to be the center, and with talent like you saw this evening, especially Lizzie, how you brought everybody together, this is what the world needs. The world needs to have, to be sameach in our hearts. So I want to say yasher kochech to you. May you go from strength to strength. I know you're going to be an incredible cantor, make an incredible contribution to the world of Jewish music, but more importantly to the Jewish world and to every world that you touch. Every world. Because I believe that no matter what world you touch, I believe that you can be in many different worlds. You can be in the pop world, you can be in the musical theater world, you can be in the rock and roll world, you can even be in the reality show world. And still, and by your own godliness, you create wonderful, great mirth and fun. And I want you to, so I just, you gotta, look at this. I've never seen anybody smile more than she does. By the way, you guys should never have stopped. If you had three more sets of triplets, you could have been bigger than the Mormon Tabernacle Choir. I mean, look at all that talent, but vocal talent. I'd like to have your DNA to see what is it in your DNA that causes the vocal cords to be so good.
Just don't ask them to sing.
Don't ask them to sing, okay? It skipped a generation. I didn't say that. No, she said that. Anyways, thank you all for being here this evening. I know there's a...
Thank you to Temple Emanuel for hosting this concert, this recital. and for providing a wonderful reception in the room behind us. And I don't want to forget to thank Jen Paul and Allison Warshall from Temple Emanuel, who printed the programs, who made this all happen, who really...
Sound.
this. And this is the story of my life. please enjoy the reception. Thank you to Launch, Daniel Tater, who grew up with me here, for the wonderful sound. And let's go have fun. Woo!